all of a sudden, kaboom! It was like, man, shook the house, you know?
People in Cape Coral say it felt like an explosion, sounded like a grenade, and sent shrapnel spiraling around their neighborhood. But it was actually lightning that shot through a light pole. Look at this right here. It is what is left of a lightning guard after this morning's lightning strike rocked Southwest 11th Avenue. It just scattered ceramic pieces across yards. Our Alex Howard is getting you more tonight on what neighbors say could have been a deadly strike.
A man who saw it said it sounded like a grenade had exploded. And now people in this Cape Coral neighborhood are literally picking up the pieces.
Boom! It was like, man, shook the house, you know?
It's part of Jim Lilly's daily routine.
I sit out on my lanai, have a cup of tea, relax, let the dog out.
But today started with a jolt.
You know, we had a heavy rain. We're like, wow, that's quite a storm. I looked at my phone, and when I looked at my phone, I said, it says lightning right above a 0.0, and all of a sudden, kaboom!
That explosion, a lightning strike at the top of this electrical pole, it sent debris flying.
The part that the lightning actually struck just exploded like a grenade, and it went all over my yard.
Today, Jim was picking up shards of what LCEC told us was likely a lightning arrester, used to minimize lightning damage to power lines.
I don't want my dog to get his paws cut up on this stuff.
Reminding Jim of the awesome power of nature.
It's shocking until you actually experience it. You don't realize the sheer power of lightning, you know? It's like, whoa!
And people who live on this street told me that they did lose power for about an hour after the lightning strike, but LCEC was on scene to repair the damaged pole within 10 minutes. In Cape Coral, Alex Howard, ABC 7.
Alex, thank you very much. Let's bring in Chief Meteorologist John Patrick.
Yeah, he's getting us more on how lightning forms during our Florida storms.
We actually have some lightning going on in the Gulf of Mexico right now, and it's quite common, especially this time of the year, as we have our sea breeze and a lot of heat and humidity, to see some of these lightning bolts and lightning strikes across Southwest Florida. First and foremost, you've got to form a thunderstorm, and that happens with warm air. That warm air rises, and as it does so, it creates that cumulonimbus cloud, and that moisture condenses and cools and forms water droplets and ice particles that start to collide within the thunderstorm. Those collisions create positive and negative charges within the thunderstorm, kind of like when you rub a balloon against yourself, you know, your hair rises. Well, that's a charge within your hair from that balloon. So as we go through time, those charges kind of organize themselves with the positive charges toward the top of the thunderstorm and the negative charges at the bottom of the thunderstorm, which makes the ground underneath that storm positive. So you've got positive, negative, and positive. And then the energy from the negative charge meets the leader from a positive charge. That happens both within the cloud, cloud to cloud, and then cloud to ground. Those are the lightning strikes that we see at the ground. And then that also can happen miles away from the storm, up to 10 miles away from the storm. Those are some of those big boomers that you hear, those bolts from the blue that we call them, and those can be the most deadly types of lightning strikes. And we're going to see more thunderstorms creating lightning strikes tomorrow. I'll have an hour-by-hour look in your most accurate forecast coming up.